वेरी गुड आफ्टरनून चिल्ड्रन, दिस इज एल के त्रिपाठी। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, एज वी हैव बीन डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द मार्जिनलाइजेशन, दैट इज योर सिविक्स पोर्शन। इन द सेम कंसर्न वी शैल वॉच द नेक्स्ट वीडियो ऑफ द सेम चैप्टर। द टॉपिक इज कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल प्रोविजंस for the protection of marginalized. The leaders of independent India wanted to establish equality in society. Equality is one of the basic principles of Indian democracy. No doubt about that. All the political leaders of independent India wanted to establish the equal society in which the interest of all people could be secured and without any discriminatory treatment people should enjoy their equality is one of the basic principles of Indian democracy. The leaders realized that the marginalized section need to get some special privileges so that they can easily come at par with the rest of the people in the society. The first amendment to the constitution passed in 1951 allowed the states to make special provisions for the advancement of socially and educationally backward classes of citizens. That is the scheduled caste and scheduled tribes. The constitution aims to protect the interest of the marginalized sections, though a threefold strategy. This is very true. The Indian leaders realize that the marginalized section need to get some special privileges. They should be given the special status, a special place in the society, so that they could get their better position in the society. For that, an amendment took place in the constitution. The first amendment to the constitution passed in 1951. First time the constitutional amendment took place in 1951. It allowed the states to make special provisions for the advancement of socially and educationally backward classes of citizens, that is the scheduled caste and scheduled tribes. To maintain the position of SCs and STs and other backward classes, the amendment was made. The constitution aims to protect the interest of the marginalized sections, though a threefold strategy. The main aim of the constitution was to protect the interest, to safeguard the interest of the marginalized section, and for that a threefold strategy was met. First, by providing measures that would ensure equality and abolish discriminatory practices. Number second, by acts of positive discrimination, means there should be the positive discrimination in the society with other sections, where preferential treatment is given to the marginalized sections. Number three, by providing resources and benefits for the overall development of the marginalized sections. So these were the provisions in the Constitution was to amend it, and the first amendment, constitutional amendment, took place in 1951 in the favor of SCs, STs and other backward classes. Now the fundamental rights. The Constitution safeguards the rights of all the citizens of the country by giving them certain fundamental rights which are essential to the security and well-being of the citizens. Let's read about some fundamental rights which directly benefit the marginalized communities. Right to equality. The right to equality states that all citizens are equal in the eyes of law. It prohibits the state from discriminating against any citizen on grounds of religion, race, caste, sex, or place of birth. Article 16 ensures equality of opportunity to citizens in matters relating to employment or appointment to any office under the state. However, the state can make provisions for socially and educationally backward classes which are not adequately represented. Article 70 forbids the practice of untouchability in any form. Next, that is right against exploitation. What was right against exploitation? Article 23 and 24 provide two provisions. Provision of forced labor and provision of employment of children below the age of 14 years in hazardous jobs such as those in factories and mines. Cultural and educational rights. These rights aim to preserve India's rich cultural heritage. They allow every citizen to preserve his or her own language and script. This is the educational and cultural rights, and these rights provide the right to preserve the Indian culture and heritage, maintain the dignity of the language script, promoting financial, getting grant financial aids to institution promoting a distinct language script or culture to protect and develop it. Next, right to constitutional remedies. What is this? This is such a right mentioned in Article 32. Empowers all the citizens to approach the Supreme Court of India to seek enforcement or protection against violation of their fundamental rights. It provides a remedy in the form of fundamental rights.
अरे दरोगा जी, किसी को बुला के टंगवाइए, वीडियो बन रहा है, समझ जी आए किसी ने तो लगेगा क्वेश्चन होने, उधर से बताना पड़ जाएगा खींच रहे थे।
द राइट टू एजुकेशन दिस केम इन टू इफेक्ट ऑन 1 अप्रैल 2010. It states that every child who has attained the age of 6 years shall have the right to be admitted to a neighborhood school and receive free and compulsory education till he see is 14 years of age. Directive principles of state policy. The directive principles of state policy are guidelines to the central and state governments in India to be kept in mind while framing laws and policies. These directives aim to provide social justice by treating all the people in the society equally. Now, reservation. One of the means of bringing the marginalized sections in the mainstream of society is through reservations. Reservations are special provisions for the marginalized sections to ensure political participation of the marginalized sections. Seats have been reserved for them in the central and state legislatures and also in local government bodies. In government services, some percentage of the jobs are reserved for the scheduled caste, scheduled tribes, and other backward classes. In institutes of higher learning, some seats are reserved for these communities. Welfare departments in the Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment look after the welfare of these groups by implementing developmental programs. Now, the national commissions. About the national commissions, we shall study. That is very important commission mention under Article 338 and 338A. To effectively implement the various safeguards built into the Constitution and other legislations, the Constitution under Article 338 and 338A provides for two statutory commissions, the National Commission for Scheduled Castes and the National Commission for Scheduled Tribes, acts and commission for the protection of marginalized classes. Number one, Scheduled Castes and Scheduled Tribes, that is prevention of atrocities, Act 1989. Second, bonded labor system, that is abolition, Act 1976. The child labor, that is provision and regulation, Act 1983. National Commission for Scheduled Castes and Scheduled Tribes. So, this is under the National Commission of India. Rest we shall see in the next video. Till then, goodbye.